Given the rational function f of x equals 2 divided by the quantity x plus 2 squared, we want to find the domain of the function, complete a table of values, and then graph the function. To find the domain of a rational function, we want to find the x values that must be excluded from the domain. And since division by 0 is undefined, we want to determine which x values would make the denominator equal to 0. Notice if we set the denominator equal to 0, it's already in factored form. This would be equal to 0 when the quantity x plus 2 is equal to 0, or when x is equal to negative 2. So the domain of our function would be all real numbers except x equals negative 2. Knowing the domain is helpful for a couple of reasons. First, if the x value or the 0 of the denominator is not also a 0 of the numerator, then we'll have a vertical asymptote at this value. So we have a vertical asymptote at x equals negative 2, which would be this vertical line here. Remember, a vertical asymptote is a line the graph will approach, but never cross. And this is very helpful for making a sketch, as well as for completing the t-table. So we're going to put negative 2 in the middle of our table, let's say here, and then we'll select x values that are greater than negative 2 on top and less than negative 2 on the bottom. And that should give us enough information to make a nice sketch of the graph. But to start, we do want to select x values that are pretty close to negative 2. So for a value that's greater than negative 2, we'll use negative 1.5 to start. And for a value that's less than negative 2, we'll use negative 2.5. And then from here, let's go ahead and use negative 1, 0, and 1. And here we'll use negative 3 and negative 4. Now to find the corresponding function values or y-coordinates, we would perform substitution into the function and then evaluate. But for this video, we're going to use the graphing calculator to speed things up. So the first thing we'll do is type in the function. So we're going to press y equals, type in 2 divided by the quantity x plus 2 squared. Let's take a quick look at the graph on the calculator before we use the table of values to complete this table. If we press zoom 6, we'll have the standard window, and we can see that we do have a vertical asymptote at x equals negative 2, and we also see the two pieces of the function. But to complete our table of values, we'll first change the table set. So we'll press second window. We're going to start our table at negative 4, the smallest value in our table. And then because we have negative 1.5 and negative 2.5, we're going to make the change in the table 0.5. And we also want the independent option on automatic, which it is. So now if we press second graph, we can complete the table of values. So when x is negative 4, y is equal to 0.5. And when x is negative 3, y is equal to positive 2. When x is negative 2.5, y is equal to 8. Of course, at negative 2, the calculator is showing an error because negative 2 is not in the domain. And notice at negative 1.5, y is also equal to 8. So this is 8. This is undefined. This is also 8. And now we'll scroll down. Notice at negative 1, y is 2. At 0, y is 0.5. Which would be the y-intercept, and at 1, y is 0.2 repeating, which we'll go ahead and round to 0.22. Notice when x is equal to 1, if we perform the substitution by hand, the denominator would be 1 plus 2, or 3 squared, so we'd have 2/9. But when graphing coordinates, it's often helpful to have it in decimal form, so let's use the decimal approximation of 0.22. Now we'll go ahead and plot these points and sketch our graph. So 1, 0.22 is just above the x-axis here. 0, 1 half, or 0.5 would be here, negative 1, 2, and negative 1.58. So here are the points on the right side of the vertical asymptote. And then for the points on the left side, we have negative 2.58, should be here, negative 3, 2, negative 4, 1 half, or negative 4, 0.5. And before we make our sketch, there's one more thing that we should discuss. This rational function also has a horizontal asymptote. As x increases to the right, or gets larger and larger, notice how the denominator would also get larger and larger, and the numerator would stay at 2. So if we have a fraction with a fixed numerator and an increasing denominator, it will approach 0. So y equals 0 would be a horizontal asymptote. To get a better feel for this, let's go back to the calculator. If we go to our table here and press the down arrow, we can see what happens to the y values as x increases. You can see how it's decreasing, getting smaller and smaller, approaching 0. Therefore, we have a horizontal asymptote of y equals 0. And the same is true if we let x decrease to the left on our graph here. Notice once we pass the vertical asymptote, y begins to decrease and again approach 0 to the left as well. So our graph would look something like this. So again, we had a horizontal asymptote of y equals 0 and a vertical asymptote of x equals -2. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.